Hello, today we'll be learning about integration testing and we will begin with its definition. So the definition of integration testing is as follows. When individual software modules are integrated logically and tested as a group. What this means is we have individual components. So first we group them, then we perform testing on them. To understand this concept better, let's use an example. Suppose our customer has given us this requirement. If the speed of the motor is more than 150 kilometers per hour and temperature value is greater than 120 degrees, then switch off the motor. So they want to switch off the motor when the speed is greater than 150 kilometers per hour and temperature is more than 120 degrees. Now, let's say the developer has written this code for the requirement and we want to perform integration testing on it. We already know that to perform component testing, we have to take each of these functions and test them separately. For integration testing, we have to take at least two components like A and B and test them together. What we are checking here is, if the value of speed in A is rising, is the value of temperature in B also rising? This shows us the interaction between the two modules. We can also perform this test on components C and B. Just remember that you have to take at minimum two units to perform this test. At maximum, you can take all three components together. Now, let's take a look at the levels of integration testing. The first level is component integration testing. The second level is system integration testing. The first point here is component integration testing focuses on interactions and interfaces between integrated components. So, in component integration testing, we check interactions between two individual components. But when you are in system integration testing, you check interactions and interfaces between systems, packages, and microservices. If there are multiple systems, then we check the interaction between those systems. Next is, when is component integration testing performed? It is performed after component testing. Similarly, system integration testing is performed after system testing. The final point is iterative. Component integration testing is part of continuous integration process. When you develop a code, you do a component testing, then an integration testing, and so on. It is an iterative process. And this is done by external organizations. Some companies give part of their software to different smaller companies to test and develop. When the components come back to the main company, they test to see if they are all working well together. So this is what you need to know about component and system integration testing. You should mainly remember that component integration testing is done after component testing, while system integration testing is done after the system testing. That's all from me on this topic. I'll see you next time. Happy testing.